Shalom guys, welcome to another episode here on Just Shout You Ministries. Today we're going to do something a little different. Today we're going to do a small clip. We're going to talk about the Feast of Trumpets or Rosh Hashanah and what does it mean. So, the Feast of Trumpets or Yom Teruah was a service that was done in the temple, right? And the blowing of the shofar, right? And it is established or understood from Leviticus 23, verse 23, where it says, "And again, the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the sons of Israel, saying, In the seventh month, on the first month, you shall have a rest, a reminder by blowing of trumpets, a holy convocation. You shall not do any labor work, but you shall present an offering by the fire to the Lord." So, here's a commandment for the Feast of Trumpets, right? This is where we understand that we are to celebrate this night and this day, right, and keep it holy. And so, what is the Rosh Hashanah, right, in the Jewish mindset, I believe, what does it mean? It's called head of the year, or the beginning of the year, or beginning of the civil year, right? The civil year will be what it is to us, from December to January. That is our civil, our Greco-Roman civil calendar in which we follow, right, our day-to-day lives. So this is where Yom Teruah starts, right, the month of Tishri, right? But there is another calendar that is observed in the Bible, which is the religious calendar that was established in the book of Exodus from the redemption of Israel, which is in the month of Nisan, right? That's where we celebrate Pesach, right, unleavened bread, first fruits, and Shavuot. Now, here, the Yom Teruah, or Rosh Hashanah, right, the beginning of the year, what is it, why is it so important, right? Well, it is understood that in Rosh Hashanah, right, on the seventh month, right, is when the seven sabbatical years are counted, right, that there is counted seven years, and in the seventh year, you are to let the land rest, right, and then you'll count 49, and on the fifth year, it'll be the year of Jubilee, right? So these celebrations, or these commandments that are supposed to be kept for the land to rest, were to be accomplished in the seventh month, which becomes the first month of the civil year. Okay, it's an agricultural thing, right? So the land was supposed to be, you let it rest, right? And then every 7 years you let it rest, and every 49, in the fifth year, the whole land rest, and all debts are canceled, and slaves and lands are given back to the original owners, right? And so why is this so important? Because this is what we are not only an understanding in the Feast of Rosh Hashanah, but in Yom Teruah. Also, what we as believers understand is that that is the day and the hour that nobody knows, right? We see Paul lets us know that Messiah will come like a thief in the night to those that are in darkness, but to those that are in light, we're to keep the times and the seasons, right? And so the times and the seasons are established in the Bible as the Feast of the Lord, right? The Moeds or Moedims, right? And so these feasts, as we've spoken before, are appointed times that we meet with God, right? God tells us what we're going to meet, right? And so in these meetings, we're expected to be congregated, and they are rehearsal for the times to come in the kingdom, right? So Yom Teruah is understood to be the day that Yeshua, our Messiah, is supposed to come, right? The day of the trumpets, where the trumpets are sounded, is when the Messiah will come, right? And then Yom Kippur will come after 10 days, right? The 10 days, right? The days of all, right? In which judgment will be established in the world, and then we will rejoice in his kingdom in the Feast of Sukkot, right? So these are the three feasts there, or the three commemorations that will happen in the next couple of weeks right? And so tonight, as in Yom Teruah, for this small teaching, what I want you guys to understand is the following. Be understood that we are supposed to be keeping these feasts in honor of our Messiah and in reverence and respect to our covenant to Him, right? We have to be prepared. So tonight, as you guys gather in your families and you sit for Shabbat dinner, please remember to honor our King at all times and to be aware that our Messiah might come like a thief in the night to those that are not prepared, to those that are not where they're supposed to go. Many people are waiting for a rapture to be taken away. Us, we are waiting patiently, looking to the sky and singing and rejoicing because our Messiah might soon be close to come. So please, Sameach Yom Teruah, Sameach Rosh Hashanah. We commemorate the honor of our God, the just of our King, and His holiness. Today in Yom Teruah, we blow our shofars, but we are alert and waiting for our Messiah to come. And in our way to our 10 days, the way we repent, and we are able to celebrate in His kingdom. Please be prepared. Thank you for watching. Have a great week. Shavua Tov, Shabbat Shalom, Sameach Rosh Hashanah, Sameach Yom Teruah.